The new Director General of Education in New South Wales is Dr. Michele Bruniges. She's been a senior education bureaucrat in this state, the ACT, and with the Commonwealth Government. She's also been a primary and secondary public school teacher and has taught in TAFE and the Adult Migrant Education Service. The Director General of Education dropped in for a chat a short time ago. Director General, welcome and congratulations on your appointment. The government's just set up this new online forum asking for public submissions, looking at empowering schools. What's that all about? I mean, I'm sorry, we've heard that all before.
For a long time now, both our principals and teachers have been asking for more authority and responsibility at the local school level on a number of issues. And what this consultation or discussion paper actually is about is hearing from the voice of principals, teachers, parents and communities, so that we can be informed about what decisions we make about what authority goes to schools.
You've just got the central command and control job, the Director General of Education and Communities, as it's now called, up there in Bridge Street. Are you really going to surrender power, real power, to principals and the schools of New South Wales to hire and fire the teachers?
I think importantly, if we're going to focus on teaching and learning in every classroom, in every school, in our great public education system, then it's going to be important that we look, that we align resources and decision making to the place that needs to make it best for students.
You would be prepared to give principals that power?
On issues in terms of the staffing mix, we need to look at it, but we need to actually listen to what they're saying will make a difference to support students teaching and learning.
Who would take the final decision on the removal of a teacher, for example?
Along the continuum of practice, the hiring and firing in teachers certainly up the most contentious end, and what we need to do is to look at, on this end, centralising, which the New South Wales system is probably the most centralised across our country. On this end is the contentious debate about hiring and firing teachers, and what our consultation is about is listening about what we see on that continuum, the mix of staffing, how schools manage resources. But in terms of the hiring and firing of teachers in schools, some of that comes with a huge administrative burden that would be better off done by the central system, so that principals and teachers
Okay, principals, focus. Principals could say, I want to get rid of this teacher. I've got somebody else that can fill in a better position.
The issue of performance management of staff in schools, principals have always asked for a greater say in that. But the actual hiring and firing and the administrative burden that comes behind that, I actually think is better off away from the school.
OK, I understand there are industrial relations implications for anything. What about transfer system? Because I noticed Adrian Piccoli, the minister, said is almost music to the Teachers Federation's ears, I'm sure, that they're not going to change the transfer system.
The incentive transfer system, I think, has served New South Wales very well for rural and remote schools in terms of hard-to-staff areas, and I think we should listen to what is actually people are going to tell us during this consultation phase and take that on board to determine whether it is still a system that serves us well.
What about resource allocation? Because talking about empowerment of schools, we're supposed to be merging the New South Wales education system into COAG's national curriculum. So all resources will have to be centrally allocated to meet agreed objectives according to the national curriculum.
Look, the national curriculum, I think, is a significant step forward, but what we have to do in New South Wales is make sure that we hang on to the syllabus structures and things that teachers have found serves them very well.
New South Wales is said to have some quality elements that should not be abandoned.
Absolutely, absolutely.
And you'll fight for them?
Absolutely. And I think at this point what we've seen in New South Wales, the New South Wales Board of Studies is taking the national curriculum framework. They're putting in place syllabuses that take on board that but give teachers a much finer degree of detail in teaching and learning context, and that's been well received for a long time in New South Wales setting.
Just briefly, where do you stand on Julia Gillard's My School website? I know it hasn't been in contention recently, but the entire parent, principal and teacher lobby has been against it because of its unfair or inappropriate comparative NAPLAN data. What about you, Director General?
I think My School has opened great discussion and debate about performance of schools, but I have to say I'm very clear My School provides one source of evidence at one point in time on some aspects of literacy and numeracy, and what we have to do is locate that source of evidence in a much broader, fuller picture about
work
what schools...
Work in progress.
Absolutely.
Okay. Now, the feds have recently established the Gonski Review, David Gonski Review, into equitable school funding. That's a very loaded term, equitable school funding, because of the contentious nature, private versus public schooling. Is this a threat, possible threat, to the funding of public education system? Because apparently they're looking at a new system based on the cost of educating students to a required standard, making non-government schools take struggling or challenging students.
Mm. Well, we're yet to see the recommendations of the Gonski report, but I see the Gonski review as a once-in-a-generation opportunity to look at the way in which schools are funded. So I'd hope at the end of the recommendations, I mean, for me as Director General, it's important that New South Wales students are best served by the recommendations of this, and that's both in terms of public school students. I think, you know, the reason for the review is something wasn't right. Something simply wasn't right, and this review is
loaded,
an opportunity.
Well, what do you mean something wasn't right? It was loaded against the public system?
I believe that the model did not address the needs of student characteristics, that was based on a measure that was around socioeconomic status, and I think the Gonski review is a great opportunity to look at the characteristics of the students and take that into consideration so that we ensure that funding goes to areas of greatest need.
There's a lot of politics in that, a lot of constituent politics in that.
There is indeed, but I think this opportunity for the Gonski report to come down and recommend, that's the challenge. So we look forward to the recommendations of the Gonski review.
Now, finally, Director General, you face a pay dispute in your new job with the Teachers Federation, the all-powerful Teachers Federation. Are teachers worth more than 2.5% cap that the O'Farrell government's put on all public sector workers?
The government position on this issue is very clear. It's a minimum of 2.5%. In the education sector, what we're going to do is we'll start negotiations with the New South Wales Teachers Federation a bit later on in the year. And I've in the past had a good
relationship. Are teachers worth more than 2.5%? Inflation is up on the higher end of the range.
Every teacher in every classroom is worth a great deal to the work that they do. The industrial situation and the salaries, the government position, as I said before, is very clear. We'll go into negotiations, and I look forward to those negotiations and hope that we can come to those, both parties, in the spirit of being able to get a great outcome.
Director General, good luck to you. Thanks very much.
Thank you.